The Lego Ninjago movie is directed by Charlie Bean, Paul Fisher, and Bob Logan, and it has 6 writers. Oh boy. It stars Dave Franco, Jackie Chan, Michael Peña, Kumail Nanjiani, Fred Armisen, Olivia Munn, and Justin Theroux, among others, and tells the story of Lloyd, a boy who's secretly a ninja with his 6 friends, and he is the son of Lord Garmadon, an evil villain who constantly attacks the city of Ninjago day in and day out, and Lloyd has to face the fact that he is being scrutinized throughout his life because he is the son of this villain, but yet secretly adored at the same time by the city because he is a ninja. I like this twist on the Spider-Man thing because Lloyd is hated by everyone for being who he is as a son of Lord Garmadon, but loved because he is a superhero ninja who constantly saves the city. And that creates for some very good comedy, not only between him and Lord Garmadon and the dynamic as father and son, but also because Lord Garmadon himself doesn't know that he is the Green Ninja, who is his biggest rival. And the group of ninjas themselves reminds you a lot of Power Rangers, their color scheme, the way they go into their cave where their mechs are, they have individual mechs who don't transform together to make a mega mech, but still, their dynamic is very good. The setup for this movie is very good. The characters are very distinct and the actors bring a lot of life into them. The city itself almost becomes a character as well, and the animation is gorgeous. Fluid, vibrant movements from characters and elements within the frame, and again the city itself, beautiful, gorgeous backgrounds that stand out beautifully so, and seamless blend between stop motion animation of the Legos and CGI to create these scenarios and sets. The movie is also very funny in general, the tone is very light and very consistent throughout. But then, this movie runs into some problems. Earlier this year, we had the Lego Batman movie, and I really liked that movie in general. That was a very funny, very good movie. But then the finale of that movie relied on a kind of throwaway joke and made the finale depend on it. The Lego Ninjago movie commits the same scene. What was once a very funny joke that really brought something new into the film and really made the animation stand out even more in a brilliant way, kind of makes the finale feel very bland. But unfortunately, that's not its only problem, because after we get fantastic world building and fantastic setup of characters, and we get these characters launched into what could be a very fun and very dynamic adventure, it kind of goes down a little bit in terms of excitement. This movie slows the hell down for the exact same reason that the 1995 Mighty Morphin Power Rangers movie became kind of eh. They go on this journey that really boggles down the main conflict of the film, and the meat of the film itself becomes subdued by so many subplots that come back again, unnecessarily so, just like they come back yet again in the finale, and they make the movie rely on it. The Lego Ninjago movie, for the most part, is very fun, and the animation is fantastic. They take a lot of chances, and they do a lot of things that they did well before in this Lego cinematic universe, let's call it. The characters are fun and funny, the actors are giving it their all. This movie had a lot of writers, clearly, because it has so many subplots, but its biggest sin is that it makes those subplots the meat of the movie, and they really boggle down what could be a very fun and interesting main conflict, because in the beginning, the dynamic between father and son shows to be promising. The Lego Ninjago movie is not bad per se. I had fun with this movie. I will not seek to watch it again. I might pop it up if I find it on Netflix. I had fun, but unfortunately, I have to say that whether you watch it or not, your heart will go on. What did you think of the Lego Ninjago movie, my beautiful geekies? Did you enjoy it? Did you not? Are you a fan of these Lego movies? What is your favorite amongst the 3 or the 2 if you haven't seen Lego Ninjago yet? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. You guys are the freaking best. I love you all from the bottom of my heart. This week I'll have reviews for Flatliners and Good Time and Gerald's Game on Friday. Can't wait to see you there. And so until then, you stay beautiful, you stay geeky, and if you haven't done so yet, click the subscribe button and the bell so we can be geeky united!